Unfortunately, with the good news we have, there's also some bad news. Regular attendees of these meetings often hear me or other board members speak proudly about the strength of the BBG team. We say this because we recognize that every success we share derives solely from the work of everyone here and in the field and the work of so many others. In short, it is our people that give such meaning to this organization. On that note, today I'm sad to announce the departure of one of the most important members of our team, Jeff Trimble. After 21 years in U.S. international media, Jeff will depart at the end of the month to Ohio State University, where for the next year he will teach and conduct research into some of the less explored factors behind the demise of the Soviet Union. Jeff joined RFERL in 1997 and then the BBG in October 2007, most recently as the first deputy director of the BBG. I know CEO Lansing agrees that this will be a big loss for the BBG. Jeff has been our subject matter expert on Russia and the former Soviet space, on BBG programming across the board, and on so much more. We're sad to see Jeff leave. Jeff, please join me and CEO Lansing at the podium so we can present a Career Achievement Award to you.
Can I change my mind? Ken, John, thank you very much. To the extent that I've had any success in the time that I've been in U.S. international broadcasting, it's because of the hard work and the incredible dedication of everybody else who works here, and that includes many people in this room and, of course, many, many people around the world. But my greatest satisfaction in working here has been when it all goes right, as it does so often. I was delighted to see it happen last week. I was on the Maidan in central Kiev, standing next to a young journalist for the Current Time Network, Volodymyr Runets, as he did a live two-way with Roman Mamonov for Current Time America on the weird episode that had taken place with the supposed murder of a Ukrainian journalist. Everything worked just right, and it was especially right because it was an RFERL person working with a VOA program to make a product that in the end was greater than the sum of the parts. Fantastic. My biggest regret is the list of names on the memorial wall downstairs. I think every day about what more we can do to keep our people safe. That's what matters the very most. And it was a very sad occasion that we had this morning. I have a really special opportunity. I've spent about 25 years thinking about the collapse of the Soviet Union, which I had the privilege of covering while I was a journalist in Moscow, and I began unpacking some boxes a few months ago, and it got me very excited to see some things I hadn't looked at and thought about in that detail in a long time. And Ohio State has offered me the opportunity and the support to be able to go into more detail of that research, and I think with the fullness of time that there are some new things to be said about the collapse of the Soviet Union, what brought it about, and the consequences of those historic events. So I'm going to produce something between a tweet and a book. I'm not quite sure where it will fall, and I'll let you know about that. I'm very comfortable leaving BBG because of the team that's working here now, and that goes from the bottom to the very top. John Lansing has set an incredible standard here. The accomplishment of bringing together the ICC, of seeing the networks work together as never before, is just fantastic for U.S. international broadcasting. In fact, the whole is greater than the sum of the parts here. The new people John's brought to the agency and the way that they've blended in and worked with the really dedicated veterans who have the experience and the talent to keep things going is fabulous to watch. I'd like to thank the board members for their continued commitment to public service and their willingness to keep along the stewardship of this very valuable, very important element of the U.S. government. And, you know, I'm from, like John Lansing, I'm from the Midwest, and we often joke, right, you've all heard me say this, that the guys, about the guy from the Midwest who loved his wife so much he almost told her. I was saying to Adam Powell just before the meeting that people don't go into journalism because they're happy with the status quo. They go into journalism because they want to make something different. In my case, I came into journalism as Watergate was happening around us, and I was very inspired by the role of the press then. Adam had his own reasons for coming into journalism that we discussed. But I've never felt that passion more than I've felt it here, talking with people in the language services and the news operations. Their passion, their commitment, their desire for change. It's not about the status quo. It's about using the power of the truth to make things better for people. And I will never lose that. I'll continue to support you all in the years to come. Please come out to Columbus. I'm just going to be there for a year, but I know many of you have ties to the Midwest. I'd welcome having you as guests. In order to pay my way, I have to teach a journalism class this fall and a political science class in the spring. So I'm very much looking forward to that. I look forward to saying goodbye to you individually here in the course of the month. Thank you all for your support and your friendship, and I look forward to keeping in touch. Thank you.
Jeff, for your passion, your dedication, your counsel, on behalf of the board, we will miss you. We wish you the very best.